Hello, Wainel community. Janne back again. And today I'm going to do a video for Nick. Nick Rudow. Nick has reached the first baby step, 100. Then he wants to celebrate that with a contest. He wants us to show our 5 to 10 favorite blind buys. But before I start, let's talk a little bit about Nick. Nick is a youngster that have pretty interesting music tastes. He sits in his sofa displaying all kinds of stuff. He's mostly into jazz, and very good jazz indeed. So if you are into that, check him out. I will leave a link below so you can go in and subscribe to his channel, support him, because he needs supporters. So let's jump into blind buys. I will start with the first one that I got when I was a teenager. This is a well-used album. I didn't buy it new. It was in a second hand, I think. And this is an American band called Aches, and this record is called Nemesis. This one is from 1983, and this is pretty cool rock. Some of the tunes go with classic hard rock, some of them are in the AOR kind of style, and most of the tunes goes in the vein of Molly Hatchet. You have some cool tunes like Heat in the Street and Young Hearts that are really catchy ones. These are the guys. Pretty cool album. And I was pretty happy to find this band, because then I bought the rest of their albums. Okay, sorry for the tongue slip there. I will put in a sample for this. Stay tuned. I'll be right back. Next one I have is a band called Skull. American hard rock from 91. I actually bought this as a blind buy because I saw Kulik in the back, and that it was produced by Eddie Kramer, the famous producer. In my fantasy back then, when I had this in my hand and I grabbed it, I thought the guy was Bruce Kulik, but it's actually Bob Kulik. Even if Bob Kulik is well known, it's well documented, being a band like Balance, where the singer Dennis St. James comes from as well, or Feldman, as it's actually his name is. And this is pretty good. And we have some other dudes. Here we have them. Closing. We have Kjell Benner plays bass here. He was actually a short period in Quiet Riot. And then we have Bobby Rock on drums, who played with Winnie Winsett. So this is what's a pretty actually good blind buy in the term of the confusion and misunderstanding with the Kulik guy. I will have a clip for you. be right back. Next one I have is Buffalo with a pretty amazing cover, the album Dead Forever. This is a band from Australia, and this is actually released in 72, but I bought it much later. And this is pretty good rock, where you have the poppiness from the Faces and the rock attitude from the band Free. So check this up if you are into that. I will have a clip for you. Next one I have is Incredible Hog with the album Volume 1. This was an interesting project. The aim for these three English dudes was to use the melodic poppiness and the hard rock to create something new, with meaningful lyrics and intelligent craftsmanship to create great tunes, ended up to be a great Sikh band. This one is from 73, Incredible Hog. I will have a clip for you. Next one I have is Chelsea Crowell, Crystal City. This one I actually bought just because she is the daughter of Rodney Crowell and Rosanna Cash. And I was pretty surprised when I put it on and let it spin, because this is a great album. It deals with lost love, and that it's mixed with the adventure journey and moody roots. Pretty good. Check this up. Crystal City. I will have a clip for you. Enjoy. Be right back. So I choose to stay alone. And I don't know for how long.
and a man. I slept in a tree and hidden out of view. Seasons and seconds while I watch for you.
One I have is two catafalque. I'm not really sure if I say that correctly. Sorry if I butchered the name. And this album Skugur. If you check the cover art, you can see it's brilliant. I just got hooked when I picked this up from the record bin. And I thought this was an Icelandic band. But I was wrong. This is a project by a Hungarian guy called Thomas Katai. I'm not really sure if I say that either correctly, but anyway, this dude moved to Scotland many years back, and mostly because he was inspired by the Highlands of Scotland and Skugur, or how you say it. That means on the top of the mountains. Music on this is very mixed. It's blending many different genres. Mostly it uses the folk influences, and it's topped with electronica, noise, metal, some black metal, but it's very interesting. I will have a clip for you so you can at least get a little hint of what this is. Last blind buy I have is this one, Jan Garbarek. I took up the runes. I bought this because I saw the rune script on this cover and I thought it was something else. My idea was probably that this is a rockish album, but I was wrong. This is actually fusion, jazz rock fusion. And this Norwegian saxophonist is amazing. And this album is a total game. You have to get this one. It's so beautiful, so moody. The atmosphere is so touching. It's so, it's incredible. Even if it's made on the boring ECM label, as many says, I don't care. I like ECM. They have good stuff. And this was actually the first ECM record I got. And I got several after that. And as they had such a bad reputation, they usually can be found in the used bins or in thrift stores, so you can pick this up for no money. So I highly recommend that you get this. I get a clip for you, so you get the drift. Thank you. was my contribution to you, Nick. And I hope you enjoy it. And if I win this, I guess the postage from the States to Sweden will be enormous. So I think I will pass the gift further along. And I was thinking, depends a little bit about the price, but we figure it out. I have a few names in mind. Okay, take care and Fridens.